Hi, and welcome to my video about what is continuous exploration. Please note that everything that I'm saying and everything that I'm showing you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox, take out of this toolbox what fits your need or what solves your problem. Continuous exploration consists of the activities hypothesize, collaborate and research, architect and synthesize. Let's have a look what we are doing there. In continuous exploration, we are getting all of these bright ideas from customer side but also from business side. We transform them into epics with a clear hypothesis statement. Then we are doing market research on these needs, and we are going also to do customer research. So we interview our customers, we try to find out what is really the problem, what are their needs, and then we are going to define a minimal architecture which proves the hypothesis, and then we define a vision, a roadmap, and a clear set of features which address the customer needs. This is continuous exploration. So, why is continuous exploration so important? It's quite simple. We need to get a real alignment between all of the stakeholders that we are having about what hypothesis should be validated or what should be built. One of the major problems that we are facing is that usually we want to build too much, but we don't really identify what things have real value and what we should really build. And this is usually the problem because we are overloading the whole system with things that have not that much value. So with continuous exploration, we are solving this problem by defining a clear process how ideas are transformed into epics, how we are going to identify the customer needs, how we define a minimal architecture, and how these ideas are then split into features and are going to be developed. So that we are able to build the right thing in a right way. So how do we do that? I have created for every one of these actions down there a video. You can see the videos up here in the links. So we are coming into this continuous exploration with all of these bright ideas from customer side, but also from business side. Then we are going into the activity, which is called hypothesize. There we are creating out of these ideas epics with a hypothesis statement behind it. After that, we are going with these epics in collaborate and research. There we are doing market research about these ideas, these customer needs, but we are also going to the customer, making some interviews, identifying the real customer need or the real problem that should be solved. After that, we are going into architect. There we are defining the minimal architecture which is needed to prove the hypothesis. Now we are going into synthesize. We have now identified the real customer need, the real problem that needs to be solved. We have a clear hypothesis and we have a defined minimal architecture to prove this hypothesis. And therefore, we are now able to create a vision and a roadmap and a clear set of features which we can bring to our backlog. With that, we are at the end of continuous exploration and at the beginning of the continuous integration. Because now we can go into continuous integration with a clear vision, roadmap, and a set of features. One of the things that I usually get asked is, how fast is this process? How long does it take through the continuous exploration? The answer is quite simple. It depends. For example, it can be that some items may go through the continuous exploration within hours. It can also be that some items will take days or some items will take weeks. But what would be wrong is that the continuous exploration takes months or even years. That would be wrong. Let's make a concrete example for the continuous exploration. For example, a customer gives feedback. He says, hey, when you would change that little filter up there in this application, if you would change that and would just a little bit change it so that it reverses the order, for example, then this would have massive value for me. So when we have such a request from a customer, we go very fast into hypothesis. We create the hypothesis out of that. So the hypothesis would be quite simple. It has a high customer need if we would change this feature. Then we go in collaborate and research. We research quickly the customer needs. We go into the architecture. We define the minimal architecture to do that, which will be quite simple. And then we bring the whole thing onto the backlog. So this little example will perhaps only take hours to go through continuous exploration. Let's go to another example, a bug. So again, a bug comes in and we go into hypothesize. Here it is very important to analyze the bug. If it's a small bug, of course, that will be quite fast, but it can also be a huge bug which changes the complete business. So therefore, we need to clearly analyze this bug. Then we go into collaborate and research. Again, here analysis is needed. If it can be that this bug relates to a not existing customer need or a not existing customer problem, or it is a problem that we have not yet addressed, and we need to define if this is really a bug or if we need to create a new feature out of that. Then we need to go into architect. Here we need to have a look at what is the impact of solving that bug. Do we need to change the architecture? And again, then we go to synthesize. There we are going to create a bug perhaps, or a new feature. And a third example, which is a huge epic, a huge idea. If we would create that new product on our website, then we would increase, for example, the number of users which buy this product by, for example, 10%. So this would be a huge epic with a huge hypothesis. And there we need now to define what would be the minimal viable product to prove this hypothesis. And with this minimal viable product, we would go into collaborate and research. We would research market needs, but also we would ask customers. Perhaps we also would create some paper prototypes to prove the hypothesis. So we are going to analyze what is the simplest way to prove this hypothesis of this huge epic. And then we will go into architect, and again we are going to analyze there what would be the minimal architecture to prove this hypothesis. And from there on we are going to synthesize. Perhaps it needs adaptation of the vision, perhaps it needs adaptation of the roadmap, but for sure we need to create some new features which we then put on the backlog. So with these three examples, you can clearly see that going through continuous exploration can be from very fast within hours to some weeks that we need to go through. What is also important here is that it can also be that we gather information in the continuous integration or in the continuous deployment or in release on demand, which then comes back into continuous exploration, where we, for example, need to do something or have a new idea or have, for example, bugs, which then needs to be analyzed and go again through continuous exploration. You can see this is an incremental continuous approach. And just to make that very clear, continuous exploration is not a 3-month cycle only because there is the PI planning. So we don't do 3 months of continuous exploration, then having everything in the PI planning, and then going into continuous exploration, which will be again 3 months. No, it is not that. It is a continuous process which goes from hours to days or weeks. The output of the continuous exploration is exactly the output of synthesize. So after continuous exploration, we have a clear vision or an adapted or changed vision, or perhaps we also don't need to change the vision at all. We have a clear set of features which we have brought into our prioritized program backlog. Of course, we also have enable features that there for the architectural runway, which enables us to bring more business value, and we have an adapted or a new roadmap. Continuous exploration is all about getting the alignment between the different stakeholders so that we identify which hypothesis should be evaluated, which brings us the biggest value, so that we are able to identify what we need to build, so that we are able to build the right thing right. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I will create every week a video for you.